Day two, so I slept till 10. Couldn't help myself. It was raining a fair amount last night, so I gotta pack up the tent, pack up the shit, maybe go get some breakfast and try to hitchhike north a bit more. All right, we are attached. Now I gotta get out of here and get soaking wet. It's a pretty decent night. I don't have a book or anything, so once I was in my tent, that was pretty much it. And I kind of miss having a big tent, a little bit, I hate to say it. But not a big tent, you know what I mean? Like a square tent instead of a rectangular one. Because it's like room to move around. And I don't know, just the way I packed in the tent last night, didn't really feel that good, so I'm gonna try a couple different ways of arranging my shit. I figured this would be a decent spot because of that broken yellow line up in the center. It gives lots of people to pass around, even though you're parked on the side of the road, but I don't know. It's been half hour, still nothing, but that's only baby steps. Half hour is basically nothing. Yeah, enough of that spot. I'm gonna walk farther down. I don't think it's a good place to be. So there's a road here that might allow people to kind of turn off and pick me up, but I really want to see what's going on past this corner, so I guess I'm gonna keep walking. Looks like there's a split lane up here, maybe a turning lane. Might be a half decent place to hitch because everything else here, as you can see, this is garbage. There is no room to pull over. Yeah, Shaggy, I'm gonna try here. It's not great, but it's all we got. And I forgot to fill up my water bottle again. Got a ride in a work truck. Oh, this run never gets easier. Hey, bud.
Very good. Where you headed?
All best, man.
Thanks.
Where you off, Joe? Daniels Harbor.
Okay. You from Daniels Harbor?
No, my father is, but I got my grandparents up there. So that was a pretty decent ride. Boyd got me to Rocky Harbor. Really not a lot of room to pull over here. Oh well, that's the Northern Peninsula for you. Word on the street is my uncle is headed this way. So I'm hoping if he sees me, he'll stop. So old man Milt just brought me here to Western Brook. This is where everyone comes to hike, and you can tell by the amount of cars, it's a popular place. So I'm hoping I'll get a ride out of here. Hopefully my uncle shows up. That'll be great. On the bright side, no matter what, all these people are going somewhere once they're done hiking. So, I'll definitely get a ride with one of them. Well, good morning. I made it to Downs Harbor. I didn't really film a whole lot in my last couple rides, and then my uncle picked me up at Western Brook, so sorry about that, but it was fairly uneventful. Here I'm sitting on a very long beach, what we call a beach here in the Northern Peninsula, which is just a shit ton of beach rocks, and looking out over a vast, unending western shoreline. Downs Harbor is absolutely beautiful. I'm so glad to be back here just chilling. I got a chance to shoe goo a bunch of my seams on my pack that I thought might rip a lot of the straps and shit too, because I'm carrying a lot more weight than I thought it would. So I got a little preventative measure going on there, and I'm just gonna skate around today and maybe take some cool photos. This place is very quaint and beautiful. I don't know if there's even 100 people living here, so it's pretty special. I think I found the site of the landslide, but I can't get in this way. I gotta go around. There's a gate on the other side that's busted, so. Signs, signs, everywhere there's signs. Blocking out the scenery. What's that other lyric? Don't listen to signs. So, that was the gate holding us back here. And onwards is the sinkhole. There's people's old basements. Houses that didn't get destroyed, but they had to pick up and move them. That's a long tradition in Newfoundland. They used to float their houses across the water. And now, God only knows, probably just put them on a truck here.
Skating on a landslide. Skating on a landslide.
Holy shit. I don't know what's safe, what's not safe, but. Oh my God. So yeah, that was pretty cool. Not really much to do other than look at the big old sinkhole, so I'm gonna keep carrying on and see what else I can find. Maybe some nice photos. The old outport photos that everyone loves. The old shitty old steel. I can't even say it. The old shitty old sheet. The old shitty old seat. Oh my God, dude. The old shitty sea shanties. Whew, that's hard. Shanty, shitty old sea shanties. Shitty old sea shanties. There we go. I got it now. I love small towns like this. Everyone who's passing you in whatever car, or truck, or ATV, they always give you a little nod and wave. Even though they don't know you, they might just assume you're a tourist, but. They're giving you the love anyways. Thank you. my time in Daniels Harbor was awesome. Love staying with the grandparents. I love just messing around in that little town, being on the beach and all the little small town amenities. I'm trying to walk to the edge of Deer Lake now, see if I can get a ride to the ferry. Got a couple hamburgers up in the Pacla. I'm set. There's lots of room to pull over here, but we're still not past that Deer Lake property, so there's not much point in me hitchhiking here when most people are going into town. Probably a 1 or 2 kilometer hike and I'll be hopefully at the edge of her. It's freaking beautiful here too. Look at the sky. All the way through Gros Morne was nothing but a Stephen King novel. Gray fog and fucking rain. Don't take long to start sweating with 60 odd pounds on your back. Passing lane 2 kilometer sign here. So at the very least there should be a spot 2 kilometers up here. And they got a hydroplane up here, it's super noisy. You can hear the hum from here. This spot here looks pretty good. There's a big ass shoulder. A lot of wind, but you know what to expect from that. So I think I'm gonna post up here just after the bridge and see if I can nick a ride off someone. Let's hope. Yeah, if you ever find yourself trying to hitch out of Deer Lake, this is the spot. Got a good beach to camp on down there if everything goes real bad. But you know, you never know. I could fit. Look at the size of me, you know as I could fit. Awesome. Ooh, thanks, fellas. Name's Travis. Oh, pleasure to meet you, brother.
Qua.
Qua? Cool. Nice.
What are you doing? Heading to Steve or?
No, I'm, my end destination is Southern United States, so I'm just trying to get off the island now. I'm headed to BC first, though. Gonna see some friends.
And coast to coast.
Yeah, yeah. I've done BC to Newfoundland twice, hitching.
Hitching?
Yeah.
No way.
Second time I did it took me like 23 days, and that was over the fall. And I don't know, there was a lot of freezing nights and huddling over fires and shit like that. And I don't think that's why I'm going south now. Oftentimes when you get stranded like in a place like this, right? Where you can, there's like an exit ramp to a town, but everything else is pretty barren. So I just cut my way into the woods a little bit and make clearing and get some, you know, deadfall for firewood. And yeah. Nothing really, just traveling around. Spent all year just stuck at home in St. John's working, and it's been a long time. Like, I don't know, if I go 6 months in one place, I start to get crazy. I've had some people that I politically disagree with pretty heavily, but like, you know, if that's the point. Get to know people and what they're about, and you're not always going to agree with them, but they're giving you the ride after all, so a lot of it is just bite your tongue. I was in this guy's car, he was taking me from Quebec City to Moncton, and he was like drinking beers the whole way, and it got real foggy, and that's like peak moose country there too, and I was just like, fuck, this is how I die. Like, a passenger to a drunk driver in the middle of the night. This is stupid, but I've only, you know what, man? I've turned one ride away my whole life, and I regret it to this day. I was outside of Vancouver trying to get out of a van, which is one of the most difficult things you could possibly do. And I was there for like maybe 40 seconds, and a car pulled over with like, I don't know, there was like 4 Sikhs in there. Like, total all smiles, like, hey, man, where are you going? And I was like, well, I'm going to Kelowna, but, like, where are you guys going? Like, Abbotsford. And I was like, fuck, man, that's actually not that far out. Like, I was really hoping to get to, like, at least a couple hours out. And I felt like, shit, it only took me 40 seconds to get this ride. I'm guaranteed another. And I stayed there for another 6 hours, man, and not one other stop. I was like, fuck, I should have took that last one. So here I go. I gotta walk again down to the highway to go to Port of Basque. I feel good, man. I'm definitely gonna get to Port of Basque today, but we're gonna have a lot of time to kill before the ferry, so we'll see. I think I picked my spot here. There's really not much room to pull over. That's like the story of my life, but should be good enough. It's right after this on-ramp. So, I don't know. Could be complicated, but could work. We'll see. I'm gonna get there. It's starting to become obvious to me that this is the end of the line, really, for Newfoundland. It's not a lot of traffic out of reason to go to Port of Basque, especially not this early in the morning. So I'm breaking one of my own rules here now, sitting on my back, but there's no cars coming. So it doesn't really matter. Normally I wouldn't do it because, you know, you don't want to look lazy. You want to look like you're having a good time, that you're interesting and you're fun, because, you know, that's your currency out here. So sitting on your pack and hitchhiking is just, I don't think it's a good idea. I don't think it's doing you any favors, let's say that much. They're all going to Stephenville. Go to Port of Basque. Take the ferry, start a new life. This highway is so desolate that I could literally, I could skate on it, you know? Like, I could have a full game of skate by myself, against myself. And like, I really wouldn't have to worry about a car. Hey,
Hey, how are you?
Best kind? How you getting on?
Where are you going?
St. John's.
Are you really?
Yeah.
I'm your lucky ticket, man. I'm going right to almost Port of Basque. Where
oh,
going?
Awesome.
Where are you going?
Port of Basque.
I'll fucking drive you if you need to go.
Yeah, God love you.
Honestly, God.
On boat?
Yeah, totally.
That's awesome. You're living the dream, too, just so you know.
Yeah, it's my favorite thing to do.
Confidence.
My favorite thing to do.
Honest to God, if we had the courage to do what you're doing,
oh,
you get in.
It's nothing. Deadly.
Yeah, so we just came from a trip ourselves.
Awesome. Sure, what is it?
It's
a void German.
We're on vacation.
Nice.
We're not bad people, we don't drink and drive, but
I knew you weren't
like
bad
you.
People. Yeah.
We're
we stopped
bad.
Pick you up.
Hell yeah. Thanks.
Man.
Thank you.
It's from Germany. We'll
this,
get you there safe, don't worry.
Oh, I believe you. Most people are like, actually like 95, probably 99% of people are best kind. And they're so lovely. And like the real arseholes, they're not gonna
99.
Stop. Dude, well at least people who pick me up.
That.
Well, people who pick me up are 99% best
okay.
kind.
Okay, you can call me 99.
Yeah. But that's how it feels when you're doing it.
Yeah, the thing is, the person that picks you up, how many people have passed you?
That's a higher ratio,
right?
For sure.
So you have to keep it
up.
Yeah, good point. Really good.
Oh, there we go, looking for you.
Looking for you.
Hitch hunters.
Hitch hunters, yeah. Hitch hunters.
There are people like that.
When we say it out loud, it kind of does sound awesome. I have a sick sense of humor.
But what we really do is get them drunk and fuck them.
Yeah.
it's
good. God love you. I'm glad I have you to protect me.
Where the fuck are you going?
I don't know. Like,
I
want to see.
Know.
I want to see Austin. Austin sounds cool.
Okay,
apparently
so
they have cool skate parks. Yeah.
Austin's big. Do you go to Subway in Austin?
I go to the skate park immediately.
To the bus stop in Austin. Where do you go in Austin?
Well, I go to the skate park immediately.
You're going to the skate park
immediately.
Okay, cool. Protest. It was on the other side of these trees.
How long
there's
is
a beautiful fucking lake.
Yeah.
That somebody came and fucking dug the road up in an excavator and said, "You're not allowed down here." And there's a protest going on. And I feel like we're advocates and we're just gonna drop in there and get.
Yes, why?
There's another road back there.
It's not the road though. Do you remember anything?
I remember going to Timmy's Cam.
Well, then you obviously don't want to remember. What are you? You're not gonna remember. You're not gonna forget this trip. I really think that's what I'm setting up to do. You said, buddy, you quoted buddy that picked you up in fucking Whitburn. Well, guess what? You won't fucking forget this fucking missus who picked you up in fucking Stephenville. She drove me on this dirt road. I thought I was gonna die. And buddy was in. Yeah, buddy, I thought buddy was gonna kill me too.
Jesus.
And you know what? Look at you are gonna, honestly, I'm changing your life right now. Just know that.
I believe ya.
I'll take you to the boat, I promise. Take the goddamn morning, that's all. Buddy, you. Now, buddy! Can you walk across water? No, I'm not doing that. I'm not fucking doing that. You're crazy.
That's
oh my god, I can't.
That's a nice top, buddy.
Yeah.
Holy fuck.
You know what?
She's driving?
You want me to take over?
Really, dude? Really?
Nice spot, holy shit. Yeah, this is awesome. What a spot.
Here you go. Little spill. Let's take a detour. So warm.
Yeah.
Good luck on your endeavors.
Appreciate
man.
It, man. I really do.
Hey, have a good one, man.
But he'll be in the wheelchair. His name is Darren.
Oh,
he'll
yes.
get you contacts. Darren!
Go on.
Take care of my buddy. Go over and talk to him. I swear to God, he'll find you, man. And lick me slip.
Take care. So that was one of the worst rides I've ever had. Not in terms of content, but just don't do that. I mean, I tried to use my judgment as best as possible, but you can't really tell if they're drunk or not. She was definitely drunk. And I'm glad that we got to the beach and I could kind of talk to her a little bit and tried to get her to let me drive, but she wouldn't let me drive. So anyway, she drove better after I'd said that, but still scared the shit out of me. I'm only 36 kilometers from the ferry now, so. But the only problem is I see I have competition. Fell up ahead, hitchhiking. Might just stay here. Man, that other guy just got a ride. Fuck. So, do I move to his spot or do I stay here? I say I stay here. It's a good spot.
Jack and Helen Devine.
Jack and Helen Devine, what a last name. My name is Travis House.
So welcome site. My last ride was fairly drunk, to be honest. It was one of the scariest rides I've ever had. Yeah, it was actually the most nervous I've ever been in someone else's car. So you guys are a welcome site.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
Good luck.
And just be careful who you're hitching a ride with.
Yes, I'll try better after that last one.
Good luck to you.
Thank you so much, guys. Have a wonderful day. Appreciate it. I made it to the boat. It doesn't leave till 11:45 a.m. It is currently 3:20. So I'm gonna be here a while. That was pretty crazy. She was definitely a lot more drunk than I thought. I didn't know she was drunk. I thought she was just eccentric newfie, right? She was definitely liquored, and she was driving like a maniac when she was excited. She was going over the double line. She was going 140 like the whole fucking way. It was pretty intense, man, to be honest with you. I've never been in a car like that at all. Anyway, that's where I knew I had to talk to her, and that's where I did, in that beach that we went to, and I was just like, listen, I am not really comfortable with what's going on right now, like, can I drive or what? I almost got away with it, but no, her ego took over. She wanted to drive, so, very good. She, at first she told me she'd take me all the way to Port of Bass, but then after I had that talk with her, she was like, no, she took her exit. So that was only 30 odd kilometers out. It wasn't a big deal, but you know, I felt bad because after she dropped me off, she was like, oh, I'm so sorry if I was your worst ride ever. I was like, well, I don't even know what I said. I was like, probably just played it cool, but that was my worst ride ever. Takes the cake. I got a new one. But then it was followed up by one of the best rides ever. And their last name was Divine. Come on. So yeah, I guess that's it for Newfoundland. I kind of apologize. We're not really doing her justice, but I just want to get off the island, I think, as fast as possible. Start the journey out west, because autumn's coming, and once that hits around here, and pretty much all the way until BC, it's just too damn cold to be at it. Especially with the gear I got, it's not very good, so gotta get out west. But I'm gonna enjoy it. I'm not gonna beeline it, kinda. Really hope you guys are enjoying this. It is a lot of fun to make, I must say. It's something else to think about, but as long as you guys like it and it can inspire someone to get out there and do some shit, that's all that matters to me. And being able to travel. If I'm not doing this, I don't know what I'm here for. That's what I'm good at. Share and like this shit, like, mad, please. Because for someone who can't pay for internet advertising, or someone who shouldn't pay for internet advertising, that helps more than anything. And if you really want to contribute, you can become a Patreon subscriber and spend like $2 or as much as you want to become of that group. And what that is you get early release all the content. If you're watching this on YouTube, the Patreon folks got it 3 days before you. You also get access to some exclusive storytelling videos, some behind the scenes stuff. And anyway, I won't plug it all here, but check it out, please, if this means something to you. If you think this is rad and you want to help me keep it going and keep my belly full, give that a look, please. So yeah, until next time, I'll see you guys once I'm done with Nova Scotia, I guess. Peace be the journey.